In this simulation, we look at S-turns, a technique commonly used by ILCA sailors when sailing downwind. ILCA was formerly known as laser. The ILCA 7 and ILCA 6 are currently Olympic classes for men and women. The simulation is quite complex, with simultaneous heading changes, S-turns, rolling of the boat, heel, sheeting and twisting of the sail, and the sailor's motions. We also added a Windex to the mast top to record the apparent wind changes. The variation of the apparent wind angle during one S-turn cycle is up to 90 degrees. This simulation was inspired by Riley Schutt's doctoral dissertation, UNSTEADY AERODYNAMICS of Sailing Maneuvers and Kinetic Techniques at Cornell University. Schutt and his team equipped a laser with an array of cameras and sensors to record all the motions and sail shape changes of the boat while sailing.
We look at six cases. Our basis for comparison is a straight line run without turning, rolling or adjusting the sheet. The second case does it all, S-turns combined with rolling the boat and adjusting the sheet, all synchronized for maximum performance. Thirdly, we look at the rolling motion and steering out of phase, to highlight how important it is to do it right. In the fourth simulation, we do the S-turns, but without roll, keeping the boat at a steady 10 degrees windward heel. In the fifth, we are rolling the boat and pumping the sheet, but sailing in a straight line. Finally, in the sixth case, we adjust the sheet pumping gently, sailing in a straight line at a steady windward heel. Results. We use the driving force coefficient Cx as a measure of merit. The S-turn technique nearly doubles the driving force of the sail when compared to the straight-line static case. Looking at the percentages, if the static run is 100%, the S-turns combined with synchronized rolling is 178%. With rolling out of phase, the efficiency drops to 112%. Maybe somewhat surprisingly, just the S-turns without rolling is more efficient than rolling only, sailing in a straight line. The boat making S-turns travels a longer distance, but only a little, 16.5 meters against 16 meters when sailing straight. That has been allowed for in the percentages. Why is this technique so efficient? If we look at the evolution of the driving force, there is a first maximum when the boat is heading up and starting to heel to windward. The apparent wind shifts towards the luff of the sail, and a vortex is formed along the mast. 2.5 seconds later, when the boat is sailing by the lee and rolling towards heeling to leeward, we get a higher maximum, with a mini tornado forming from the end of the boom up along the leech. Air pressure is low within the vortex. This manifests itself as a suction force on the sail, as witnessed by the blue color. The driving force of the sail is instantaneously increased by 70%, from the average force coefficient value of 1.23. The leech vortex soon breaks down and the driving force drops. Static pressure variations on the surface of the sail. Blue colors denote strong suction, red is positive pressure or backwinding. A look at vortices, or eddies, in a plane at 4.2 meters height. When rocking and rolling, the efficiency of any horizontal profile depends on the apparent wind speed and the profile length, that is the sail width at that height. Closer to the head, the sail moves too fast and is too narrow to resonate with the wind. Down low, the wider sail hardly moves sideways due to the rolling. Both the rhythm, or frequency of rolling and the amount, or amplitude are essential, combined with the width of the sail. In his dissertation, Riley concentrates on a sail section at this height, as it is the best candidate for producing extra driving force by creating helpful vortices. A disclaimer: almost double driving force does not mean two times faster boat speed. The simulations were all done at the same speed. With the S-turn technique, boat speed will be higher, which means apparent wind speed will be lower, which means the sail force will be less. The problem is circular. To find out the differences in boat speed, we need to resort to our VPP. VPP stands for Velocity Prediction Program. It balances the driving forces of the sail with the drag of the underwater boat. By entering the driving force values into the VPP, we can find out differences in boat speed. According to the VPP, the S-turns technique is 0.6 knots faster. That's a big difference. On a 12-minute run, it would mean over 200 meters.